Hello folks, Kyle here, Dark 30 Outdoors. Welcome back and thanks so much for watching. Hey, today I'm gonna bring you a real quick video. I'm just gonna do a simple recap of 2020 lessons learned. And then I'm also gonna kinda go into goals for 2021 for what's to come ahead on the channel. So one of the biggest lessons learned for 2020 for me was that if I'm gonna film a fishing trip when I get there, I need to get the cameras going. And that may sound a little bit intuitive, but the reality is I'm a fisherman first. So when I go on a fishing trip and I arrive, I think to get to the fishing first. And then what happened was, you know, in my mind, I'm like, well, I'll get the cameras going. Well, I'll get them going here in just a few minutes. Well, I'll get the cameras going soon. And then I catch a fish. I've got a muskie, you know, flopping around in the net in the water, and I never turned the camera on, so I didn't really capture the fight. That happened more times in 2020 than it should have. And also, my son caught about a 12-pound blue cat on his little kid fishing pole, and I didn't have the camera going for that, so I didn't capture the fight. So I really missed some opportunity to catch some really good fish fighting action in 2020. That's my biggest lesson learned from 2020 is if I'm going to film a fishing trip, I need to get the cameras going right away when I get there. And then lesson number two would be that when you're filming your deer hunting and you know, you want to capture the game if they're not right up close to you, yes, an optical zoom camera is ideal, but man, if it's got a 2-inch viewing screen, And you're trying to keep the camera 2 or 3 feet away from you so you have room to pull your bow, it's really tough to see your subject in the little 2-inch screen. So I had to kind of play around with it, move it around, and try to get it to where it was close enough that I could see, but it still wasn't in my way. So definitely a big lesson learned. This for fall 2021, I might upgrade to the next level up, something with just a little bit bigger LCD viewing screen. I'm not real sure on that. I'll cross that bridge when we get to it. It works. It was really, really cheap, budget-minded YouTuber here. It works, and I've used that Handycam for other things, and so I really do like it. But yeah, it's not great for deer hunting. And then lesson number three would probably be that traveling to new lakes is really, really fun, but doing it solo is a big challenge. You don't have someone else there with you to bounce ideas off of and to help you. They can make observations and help you discern, you know, maybe should be focusing on this or deeper water, shallower water, or let's change things up this way or that way. And then, of course, if it's a long drive, having someone to shoot the shit with, that helps too. So solo, I learned it. Solo trips to far off lakes, it's a fun adventure to explore, but you definitely want to do that with a buddy. It's pretty challenging doing it solo. Now, going into 2021, my goals, I've got several goals. One of the biggest goals is to do some collaborations with other YouTubers. I've talked with my friend David from Make It Take It Outdoors. We've tried to coordinate our schedules and get something done, and we've come close a couple of times. We just haven't gotten it done. In 2021, we're getting it done. I got to get Dave out, get him muskie fishing, get him his first real muskie. I think he caught a 15-incher, and that's not the real muskie fishing experience. So we'll get him his first real muskie. Also, I'd really like to do a collaboration with Finn Seeker TV. He's a great guy, and boy, I tell you what, he can get on the muskies too, so it'd be cool for him and I to do a collaboration. And then, I don't know, I guess I could maybe try to hook up with CJ or Todd with Boxy Outdoors over in Pennsylvania. Maybe he and I hit Pima Tuming. There's certainly opportunities, so my goal is to do at least 3 collaborations with other YouTubers in 2021. My next big goal is to catch a new personal best muskie. In the world of muskie anglers, a 43-inch muskie is not a really, really impressive fish. It's a good fish anywhere you go, but nobody's gonna look at that as a personal best and say, wow. You know what I mean? So I know I've hooked fish that are bigger than that. I just got to close the deal and get them in the net. So that's my next biggest goal is to set a new personal best for muskie. Another goal is to fish with family members or friends a lot more often. I want to get my son on his first muskie. He'll be 8 this year, so I think he's getting ready for that. So just getting more people in the boat. I upgraded my rods last year, and now I've added reels and rod holders this year, so I can definitely run 4 rods and do a lot more trips with a buddy or someone else on the boat. I think it'll make it a lot more fun. Then my last goal for 2021 is to something I missed out on 2021. I certainly tried. It's to self-film myself harvesting a deer. Doesn't have to be a monster buck. It can be a doe, buck, whatever. I just want to capture the shot and the harvest on film. That's a big goal for my channel in 2021. I kind of came close in 2020. I could have been a little bit more prepared, a little bit more shooting, but you know, excuses, boogered up elbow. I wasn't target shooting because I didn't want to wreck it to where I couldn't shoot at all. That held me back. It cost me. But in 2021, you know, if that's an issue, I got a crossbow that I can make sure that's ready to go. So kind of have plan B on the ready. And that's it for lessons learned and then goals for 2021. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching.